Father, Son, the Holy Ghost. Amen. My dear brethren, today is Sunday after Ascension. I'd like to propose 3 points of meditation. First of all, let us see the mystery of Ascension. Our Lord ascended in heaven with his body and soul, his humanity. His human nature is enthroned at the highest place in heaven. As a man, he sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty, in the throne of the Word of God himself, triumphantly. He must now receive the adoration from all creatures. His simple says, the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, of those that are in heaven, on earth, and under the earth. And every tongue should confess that the Lord Jesus Christ is in the glory of God the Father. Second point, why ascension? While our Lord was upon earth, the majority of people were ignorant of the truth of our Lord Jesus Christ. They scourged him, imposed the crown of thorns on him, and crucified him. They crushed God-man on their foot like a worm. Our good Lord accepted this unanimous treatment. He willed to take the chalice of sorrows with entire submission to the holy will of his Father. He united himself with his Father's will, with his full consent. He became the victim of our sins to satisfy divine justice. He paid most abundantly the debts of the sins of his brethren. St. Paul says, he humbled himself, becoming obedient to death, even to the death of the cross, for which cause God has exalted him and has given him a name which is above all names. The man of sorrow became the king of glory. Even I have been following the steps of his Calvary. Even I have great compassion to his sufferings here on earth. Let us now raise our heads and look up the highest in heaven. He is there right now. Third point, the consequence of the mystery. God the Father established our Lord as supreme judge of living and the dead as a consequence of his ascension. At the moment of our death, you and I will have to appear in front of the supreme judge, our Lord Jesus Christ, at his tribunal, where Son of God and Son of Man is sitting today. At this private judgment, our soul must hear the eternal sentence we merit from his mouth. And again, at the end of the world, all mankind will be gathered for general judgment. Jesus Christ will appear on the last day in his great majesty to separate the just and the wicked. His sovereign voice will resound all world. Impenitent sinners will be thrown down to hell, whereas our Lord will invite the just to come to receive eternal bliss. Also, there is another consequence of his ascension. Jesus Christ received not only the supreme power of judgment, but also royal power to rule all nations upon earth. Oportet illum regnare, says St. Paul. He must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. He must reign on earth until he shall come to judge the living and the dead, even over those who refuse to be led by his kindness, those who dare to reject him, those who try to delete the sweet yoke of his law from their coat. Our Lord shall exercise his sovereignty in the strict justice, giving them logical consequences of their evil actions and the rejections of our Lord. If men refuse the truth, they will have to suffer the consequence of lies. If sick men reject the good medicines to heal, coming from the best physician, then they will doom to prolong their illness. Conclusion, let us ask the grace to live holy faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. He will come to judge us, all of us. He is the supreme judge. And let us ask our Lord, our Lady, to share her unshakable faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, her divine Son. Father, Son, the Holy Ghost. Amen.